heard when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Church, it is such a wonderful, wonderful day to be in the house of the Lord. You may say, well, I'm in my own bedroom. I'm in my own living room. Yes, but isn't it wonderful to know that we, your body, is the temple of the Holy Spirit? It does not diminish the fact that we need to find ourselves in the assembly of the saints, but it's good to know that God walks in us. And his promise is that he would never leave us and that he would never forsake us, even during these tough times. Hallelujah. I want you to listen to this old hymn of the church.
The darkness.
Hallelujah. But for thy grace can spoil the tempter's power. Tell me
who I myself, my hope and strength will be.
My soul really does love Jesus. My soul, could you help me say, this is a week we acknowledge the presence of God in the form of thanksgiving. Is it all right if we get a jump on it? Oh, oh. Stay there in unison. Whoa, whoa. Luke, the 17th chapter.
I love him, I love him, I love him. I love him, I love him.
Luke 17 and 15. I want to read into your hearing the 15th through the...
Yes, sir.
15th through the 19th verse. Hear the beginning of the reading of God's word. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice glorified God and fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks. And he was a Samaritan. And Jesus answering said, where were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? There are not found that return to give glory to God save this stranger. And he said unto him, arise, go thy way, thy faith hath made thee whole. So far the text. We want to concentrate and lift from this text in that 17th verse. And Jesus answering said, were there not 10 cleansed? Where are the 9? Would you look your neighbor in the face and repeat this declaration? Say, neighbor, I am not responsible for your praise. All right, let's go to work. Tell your neighbor, I'm not responsible for your praise. We know that there were more than just one that was healed. What is alarming is that many of us place protocol over praise. Sure, they were commanded by the master to go and show themselves to the priest. I'm just doing what he told me. He told me to go show myself to the priest. And that was the protocol, because before a leper could be declared clean, he had to show himself to the priest, and the priest had to pronounce him clean. So that was the protocol. But as they went to show themselves to the priest, a change took place. As they went, a transformation transpired. As they went from sick to healed. All of their statuses changed from a group set aside to a group that could now be social. All of them went at one time from a marginal existence to endless possibilities. All of it happened to them at one time, but only one returned. Let's look at that 17th verse. And Jesus answering said, were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? There are not found that return to give glory to God save this stranger. Now, he's called a stranger because he is considered a half-breed. He is a Samaritan. And you know, Jesus used the Samaritans in several of his analogies and several of his teachings. As a matter of fact, when he went to the well, it's a beautiful Samaritan girl, and he told her that she should drink of the water that would be in her, a well of water, Lord have mercy. And she put aside her water pots, ran into the city, and brought the men out and said, come see a man. It was Samaritan. They were passing on the road, and a man got beat up by the hard up, passed up by the dressed up, but he was picked up by a Samaritan. And so often, we receive help from those that were not supposed to be in our little group. It's amazing how there is prejudice even in poverty. That there is prejudice even in sickness. He was in the gang because he had leprosy. But yet, when we read this text, we find out that all of them met Jesus. And the Bible says in that 13th verse, and they lifted up their voice. They cried, Master, have mercy on us. It was a chorus of all of those. Lord, I'm trying to hold on for a few. I ain't gonna hold you long. Don't move from the screen because I'm just about ready to end. It was a chorus of all of them asking in a unanimous prayer, Lord, have mercy on us. And Jesus hollered back at them and told them, go, show yourselves unto the priest. Now that to the Jewish ear was a cry of good news. For the only reason I would be going to the priest is if I was looking for him to pronounce me healed. The only reason I would be going to the priest is for him to put his stamp of approval on my miracle. And the Bible says that as they went, they were healed. And I know if this fella knew he was healed, then the rest of them had to know they were healed. But as I stated, some of us put protocol over praise. Which causes me to scratch my head to say, God, you're good to the unthankful. I know that I'm trying to be more like Jesus. Because in the omniscience of God, he would have known that the other nine were not going to come back and glorify him, and therefore he could have just healed the one. But he's so good that when he doesn't get the praise he deserves, he still works the miracle. Thank you, Jesus. And so those fellas that were of Jewish descent, that understood the protocol of the law, they said, well, I'm healed. And I'm going to keep going to the priest because the priest can give me my declaration of cleanliness. He can get me out of what I'm in. Y'all got to hear what I'm telling you. The one that you asked to heal you. He told you to go show yourself to the person that could certify the healing. But he did not cause you to, or exempt you rather, from giving thanks. And that's what a lot of us do. We try to pull rank. Well, I'm doing what he said, and I ain't got to do all that jumping and hollering and screaming that you're doing. That's just not me. I'm too dignified. As one person told me, Marvin, I don't do all that. I'm trained. I know. I know the Lord's been good to you. I know the Lord has been faithful to you. Because we were all in the same ship. We were all messed up together. And God caused his grace to fall on all of us. Hey, glory, glory, glory. And it did not, Jesus did not miss it. It did not go by him when he looked and saw. For he said, the only one that has come back to praise God for the healing that happened to him is this stranger. This individual that is not considered on the same plane as we Hebrew fellas. Yeah. Jesus told that woman at the well in John, he said, you worship what you know not. For salvation is of the Jew. Yeah, we got the leg up. We have the advantage. It was God that spoke to us. But oh, it does not exempt you from giving God the glory that is due his name. I don't care. I've heard people say, yeah, well, I got a big stature in the community. People look at me, I can't be in church crying and making a, what are they to say? Yeah. Yeah, I know you got a big stature. I know you somebody. But oh, God has done for you what no one else could. And I know a lot of people, they say, well, Pastor Winers, you've done this, and you're big here, and you're known in circles, and you've walked with those that are presidents, those that are athletes, those that are millionaires, you've walked with lawyers, you've walked with people, they know your name, and yet you come to church and you shout and you dance, yeah, because I recognize. If it had not been, ooh, I'm about to lose it now. I hope the musicians are in place because I feel a dance coming on. And the reason I feel the dance coming on is because I recognize that I was walking along with everybody else, with all the problems that everybody else had, but we ran into Jesus. We cried because of our condition and asked him to have mercy. I said, have mercy. And he had mercy. This man broke rank. He broke protocol. And everyone that was walking with him, going into the city, to the nearest synagogue, if he was healed, then they had to know they were healed. And look at these folk. Still in pride. Walking. Man, I'm healed, I'm healed, I'm healed. Yeah, you feel that? Yeah, I'm good. It's gone. I have feeling in my feet. I have feeling in my hand. Look, he's turned my skin to its regular color. Oh, my God, this is wonderful. Where you going? I'm going to the priest. But this Samaritan said, where you going? He said, I'm going back. Because I don't want to miss. Lord, have mercy. I don't want it to seem as if I am ungrateful. I don't want it to seem as if I am unappreciative for what this man, whom I have never met before, did in my life. Now watch this, watch this. You have to understand that he did not come back trying to hide what God had done. For when we look at that 15th verse, it said, one of them, when he saw he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice glorified God. I'm not trying to talk about you. I'm just talking about me. Lean on your neighbor and remind him of the subject. Say, neighbor, I am not responsible for your praise. I need you to say it again. I am not responsible for your praise. Jesus asked, where are the nine? But he asked that question to the disciples. He didn't ask it to the leper. He asked that question to those that were around him because he wanted to point out, he wanted to point out that when God does something good for you, you ought not try to hold it down and cover it and say, shh, somebody ask you, what happened to you? You should be saying, I don't want to get loud. I'm loud because God did something for me that I thought I was going to have to live with all of my life. I'm loud because I got to glorify the God that delivered me. I'm loud because I want everybody to have an understanding of what I'm doing. I am calling your attention. I am trying to make a scene. Because the God that I serve deserves to be notified and notarized. He deserves to be clamored upon. He deserves for people to laud him with praise. And we're around here trying to, hallelujah, loud. I wonder, did God do something for you loud? Did God do something that no one else could do? You ought to get loud. You ought to get loud. Some of us too ashamed to holler even in the privacy of our home. But oh, my. I'm not ashamed. Lord, have mercy. Yeah. I talked about my father, the other service. I'll talk about him some more. As a little child, it was not strange that way in the midnight, you could hear my daddy in the room praying, hey, glory. You would start her one time, but he did it so often until you were not started. That was just daddy hollering for whatever reason. Lord, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. You see, when you worship God, when your mind is flooded with all of the things that God has done in your life, then you ought not to be ashamed to make some noise. This man could care less about what you thought about him. He knew what you thought about him. He was in a community of lepers. He could not go into the greater population. He knew that you did not want to touch him. You did not want to drink after him. You wanted to wear your mask and keep social distance. You wanted to stay away from him because you thought he had a virus that was contagious. But when God healed him, Lord have mercy. Somebody want to know whinings? Why you make so much noise? It's because when I saw others that had corona that died, God brought me up. I need somebody to holler for me. Hey, glory, glory, glory. This man hollered. Came and glorified God. Not only did he get there and glorify God, I guess I need to make that note. You know, in the second chapter of Mark, they were all in a tizzy because Jesus said that this man's sins were forgiven. That was the paraplegic. And they got all up and just nervous and swelling up. Someone, who is this man? Nobody can forgive sin but God. But here Jesus makes another exclamation for those that said, Jesus never said he was God. Watch this, watch this. He said that this man came back to give glory to God. He came to give glory to God. And what did he do? He fell on his face at his feet. I'm not too proud to let a greater power know that I need him. I'm not too proud to feel as if bowing down on my face is beneath me. For the God that I serve delivered me when he didn't have to deliver me. He brought me out when he didn't have to bring me out. I really felt that I was going to live the rest of my life in the same status that I had lived the majority of my life. But I ran into a God that met me, and without a prescription, without any health insurance. Oh, I thought I was in a sanctified church. Without anybody doing anything for me, I just cried unto the master. I knew I didn't deserve it, but I told him, have mercy. I need somebody to tell God, have mercy on me. Lord, if you will, look beyond my faults and have mercy. I don't want to live the rest of my life the way I'm living now. I don't want to go through the rest of my life with the pain I'm feeling now. Lord, I know I don't deserve the least of your favors. But God, what I need is for you to be mercy seated. I need you to sit down, oh Lord, between the mercy seat. I need you to recognize that I will never be able to earn what you want to do for me. Have mercy. And Jesus took that prayer and said, you're healed. I come to tell somebody, you're healed. I come to let somebody know that you're healed. I need you to glorify God for your healing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And when he got there, he fell at Jesus' feet and kept giving thanks. Even when he was discussing the problem of the nine, he kept on giving thanks. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I am not responsible for your praise. I feel like preaching. I grew up in the church, and we have what we call altar workers. And you had to live right in order to work the altars. And me and Ronald just wanted to work the altar. Well, in the framework of the altar worker, what you would do is you would praise and worship with that individual that was trying to get through to the Holy Ghost, or trying, as we used to say, get a blessing. You would tell him, say thank you, Jesus. Say hallelujah. Come on and get glad about it. Open your mouth. Let it come out of your belly. And you know what? We had some people that no matter how much I tried to cheer them on, they still stood there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
and I'm just sweating. Come on, open your mouth. Tell him thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
To one day I just said, they don't want this. Look at your name and say, name. I'm not responsible for your praise. I don't know where the nine were and what this man was saying to us. I'm not about to leave the feet of Jesus and go find the ungrateful nine. Y'all not hearing what I'm saying, but I'm gonna keep praising him. Yes, sir. Oh, Lord, I feel like preaching. Yeah! Yes! Yes! Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Leprosy was just one of my problems. Lord, have mercy. Oh, the Bible doesn't tell us everything that was wrong with that man. Oh, Lord. But we called out the dominating factor, the biggest problem in his life. Some of you feel like there's something that's weighing you down. Oh, Lord, you have a dominant devil. You have a dominant problem. And every day you wake up, you're asking God to move the problem. Every day you get out of your bed, you're asking God to fix that dominant problem. But if the truth be told, that sickness, that poverty, that dysfunction is not the only problem you have. Oh, oh Lord, I got to close now. Let me tell you what praise does. Oh, Lord, yes, sir. While they were discussing what was going on with the other nine, that one Samaritan kept on praising. He kept on saying, you are one in my soul. He kept on crying out, I'm grateful for your touch. He kept letting him know, you didn't have to do it, but you did. Oh, thank you, wonderful Savior. Thank you, kind sir. Oh, I'll get to the priest after this, but right now, I got to praise you. Right now, I got to give you the glory. Right now, I got to pay homage to the only one that could heal me. Oh, I'm not gonna worry about where the other nine are, 'cause I'm not responsible for your praise. I come to tell somebody, sit there if you want to. Look like you're uninterested. Act like God has never done anything for you. Keep folding your hand and waving your little head. Oh, that is for me and my house. I'm gonna praise him. I'm gonna give him the glory. Yes, I am. Say yes. Yes. Now watch this, and I'm through. In that 19th verse, it said, and he said unto him, arise, go thy way. Thy faith has made thee whole. Tell your neighbor, when you praise him, you'll get more. Tell your neighbor, when you open your mouth and give God praise, when you keep praising him for the same thing, when you keep praising him for that dominant miracle, when you keep praising him for what he brought you out of, even though it happened 20 years ago, ah, Lord, When you keep praising him, you'll get more. I'm finished. All. Somebody say all. All of the 10 lepers were healed, but only one was made whole. Lord. Don't you let anyone talk you out of your praise. Because he kept praising him. Jesus told him, your faith made you whole. Which gives me to know that my praise is attached to my faith. Oh, really not gonna pray. In other words, somebody want to know, well, he did that 10 years ago. Why you still praising? Because while I'm praising, I got some more stuff that you can't see that I need God to work out. I want to take a few minutes and give God a praise break. Come on, come on. I need somebody to pray. You look foolish. Tell him, I'm not responsible for your praise, but you ain't responsible for mine. So let me praise him. Let me praise him. Let me. you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Oh, yeah, no, 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 no. Ah! Feel the praise welling up inside of you. While you praying for one thing, he's working the other thing out for you. Yes, he is. Thank you for healing me. And thank you for working everything else out. And I promise I'll give your name the glory. I'll tell the world you did it. Oh, yes. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. All by myself, ain't nobody like you. Glory, 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 glorify God, glorify God, my yanda ba 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 ba, eko do 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 si yanda ba 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 si, glorify Him, glorify Him. Glorify Him out of your belly. There's the power of the Holy Ghost come over you right now. Ah, Lord. Thank you, thank you. Reign, Jesus, reign. Reign, Jesus, reign. King of Zion, Judah's lion, reign, Jesus. The presence of the Lord is with you right there. Say it one more time. Rain.
Rain. Jesus.
Rain.
Yes, Lord.
Rain.
Rain. Jesus. Rain.
Rain. You're the King.
King of Zion.
Jerusalem.
Rain.
All of them were healed, but only one of them was made whole. Why don't you let him make you whole today? If you don't know the Lord Jesus, repeat after me, Lord Jesus, I receive you today as my Savior. Come in. Forgive me of my sins. Wash me. Cleanse me. Fill me with the Holy Spirit. I give you my life for the rest of my life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, you have heard that prayer. I know your presence is there. You've already done the work because we praised you before the protocol of showing ourselves to the King. Now certify it. You are the King
of Zion.
Receive Jesus today. Some of you have been filled with the Holy Ghost. I want you to email us. Go to salvation@perfectingchurch.org. I promise we want to walk through. We don't want to lord over your faith. We want to just be helpers of your joy. You know, I wish I could just go to my seat and sit down and let somebody else take over the service because I know it's time for me to end. But would you sing that with us one more time? Say,
rain,
Jesus,
Jesus,
rain. Tell him to
rain, Jesus, rain.
Pray God's choicest blessings upon you during this week of Thanksgiving. I want you to sow right now. I'm just asking everyone that can and will to sow a seed of $50. This is the fourth Sunday of this month. I want everyone to sow a seed of $50. We all tithe here at Perfecting Church. Lord, I feel your presence. He's still moving. Father, bless both gift and giver according to their faithfulness and according to their cheerfulness, for it's not as a debt I owe, but as a seed I sow. I want you to listen to the instructions for giving, and afterwards stay into the cyber sanctuary for the news that is going to come.
Perfecting Church has four ways to give. Text to give is quick, simple, and very secure. Text perfecting to 73256. You may also give by Cash App at $PCDetroit. Please remember to add your name, address, and contribution designation to the notes. Online giving is available at www.perfectingchurch.org. Or you may mail your contribution to Perfecting Church, 7616 East Nevada Street, Detroit, Michigan, 48234. We pray God's blessing upon you and your seed sown. Thank you for your support to Perfecting Church. Good day. Please give your attention to the Perfecting News. Get ready for a week full of the Word as we meet in the Cyber Sanctuary Tuesday night for Bible study. And then on Wednesday, it's The Gathering Youth Bible Study at 6 p.m. with Pastor Daniel Norwood. Virtual auditions for the Perfecting Youth Got Talent Show is this Saturday. Send an email today to dnorwood@perfectingchurch.org to register. Let the world experience your God-given gift. The last day to give to the PC Gideon 300 is quickly approaching. Sow your seed before November 30th and stand with hundreds of others as we build a new house of worship. Perfecting Church appreciates your support. The Academy to Perfection extends an invitation for you to experience our great Sunday school classes at a one-day open house, Sunday, December 6th. Send an email by November 30th to academy@perfectingchurch.org to obtain your free pass. The PC Evangelism Department solicits your financial support in its 27th year partnering with Angel Tree. Your gift of $10, $20, or whatever you give will bring joy to a child whose parent is incarcerated and other children in need. Your generous donation before Friday, December 11th, is greatly appreciated. Ladies, 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 it's back and better than ever. Ladies' Day, blessed to be a blessing, Saturday, December 12th, live on Facebook and YouTube with The Big Three. Save the date for an incredible day of women's empowerment and sisterhood at its best. Perfecting Church would love to welcome you to our family. If you're looking for a church home, send an email to membership@perfectingchurch.org. We pray you take time to reflect on how much you have to be thankful for as you enjoy your holiday. Happy Thanksgiving on behalf of Bishop-elect Marvin Winans and Perfecting Church. Contact our offices at 313-365-3787 if you require any additional information. Have a blessed day.
Thank you for your support to Perfecting Church. Really, pray that you have a safe, enjoyable Thanksgiving holiday. And I look forward to seeing you in the Cyber Sanctuary this week. It's a great lesson. You do not want to miss it. Father, I pray now your choice blessings upon all. I rebuke death now in the name of the Lord Jesus. That this will not be a week of death. We will not hear. It will not invade our space. I know those are saying, well, people are going to die, but not the folk that are going to give God praise here today. Stay back the hand of the evil one. I rebuke death in the name of the Lord Jesus. The power of God be made known and real in the life of those that are worshiping. Why don't you give them praise in Jesus' name, for the work is already done. Glory to God.